Hi everyone. By yesterday we have completed 3 sessions. Today we are going to start session 4. Welcome to online class everybody. So in the third session we have discussed about the unicellular and multicellular. Right? Unicellular and multicellular. Here in the session I am going to give you information or differences regarding unicellular and multicellular. So all of you please get your books, make sure that your notebooks and your textbook, if you have textbook, keep your textbooks, if not, take your notebooks and please note the points whatever I am discussing, right? See here, unicellular and multicellular, already we have discussed what is mean by unicellular. Unicellular means containing one cell, multicellular means containing more than one cell. So here you see, point 1 says about the organism made up of one cell, right? And coming to the multicellular, the organism which is made up of more than one cell. So, for made up of one cell, we can take an example of what? Amoeba, paramecium, euglena, etc. These all will come under the unicellular organism where they contain only one cell. Made up of more than one cell here is multi, many, right? Many cells contain the organism means here we itself, right? Plants, animals, human body, all will come under the multicellular organisms. For this, what we have to write an example? Humans, right? Plants, animals, these all will come under the example for multicellular organism. And in unicellular organism, simple cellular organization will be there, means the cells will organize its body with only one cell. So that we call here as simple cellular organization. When you go for multicellular, complex means more. Simple means only one, complex means more. So that complex cellular organization can be seen in the multicellular. Right? Here, single cell performs all the functions. Already we have discussed this point in session 3, right? Single cell performs all life processes. What is meant by life process, children? What are the life processes? Nutrition, respiration, transportation, excretion, reproduction, growth, locomotion. These all will come under the life process. So, to perform all these life processes, only one cell is required here in unicellular organisms. But when coming to multicellular organism, we require variety of cells. See, in our body, different type of cells are there. Different organs, different tissues, different, all the cells make an organ system and an organism. So here we require variety of cells to perform a life process, right? Now, in a unicellular, only single, the cell divides with only one fission. Fission means what, children? Dividing. The cell, for example, if this is a cell, the cell is dividing into two. Means, see, fission means breaking down. That takes place by only one single takes place. But coming to the multicellular, cell divides by complex reproductive process. By reproduction process, the multicellular will undergo to give rise to a young one. Right? So this says about the unicellular and multicellular differences. It is an important point and answer for exam point of view. Now, when coming to the shape of the cells in the human body, I think you are eager to know what are the different type of shapes present in the human body, right? So I am going to show you only some shapes. What are they? What are the names of the shapes here? See here, RBC. You know RBC? What is meant by RBC? Red blood corpuscles, or you can call them as shortly RBC, red blood cells, means blood. Okay, so RBC is biconcave in shape. See, this is called RBC. This part is called as RBC, red blood cells. Right? They are biconcave in shape. When coming to muscles, where are the muscles? See, this is called as muscle. This is smooth muscle and this is stripped muscle. These muscles are flat, elongated. flat elongated. Next, when coming to nerve cell, where is nerve cell here? See, this is called as nerve cell. This is called as nerve cell. How the nerve cell here is? See this shape. This shape is how? Like six sides, or you can call it as hexagonal, and it is like branched, like a tree, right? Like a plant. So you can say here hexagonal branched shape, right? And this middle one you see, this is called as bone cell. Bones. We have bones, right? So this is called as bone cell. This bone cell here is branched spherical shape. This is a branched spherical shape. Bone cells are flat shape, spherical shape, branched shape, depending upon the presence of bones in our body, right? And next, coming to the WBC. So children, these all will come under the WBC. What is meant by WBC? White blood cells or white blood corpuscles. So these all are, these WBC are divided into lymphocytes, monocytes, neutrophil and eosinophil. So these all are round and spherical in shape. So children, in all these are all the different shapes of the cells in the human body. In all these cells, what is the common here? Cell membrane, right? Cell membrane, cytoplasm and nucleus. But only red blood cells does not have the nucleus. See, you can compare red blood cells as well as white blood cells. See, this dark portion is called as cell membrane and this light portion is called as cytoplasm. And this here you see WBC, this dark one is called as cell membrane. And this inside portion you can see different shapes of the nucleus. Nucleus are of different shapes. They are lobed shape of the nucleus. So you can call them as lobed nuclei, right? So these all are the shapes of the different cells in the human body. Okay children, so now coming to the, these are the shapes, and then now coming to the cells are in different size, right? Cells are in different size. Small size cells you can see, large size cells you can see. So shall we go for some examples of them? Right, cells are small, right? Small cells means what is the measurement of it? 0.1 to 0.5 microns. In which you can see this one? In bacteria. You can see this one in the bacteria. Bacteria is very small. So that, see, around us, in air, in soil, in water, on our skin, wherever you see the bacteria is present. But you cannot see the bacteria because the measurement here is 0.1 to 0.5 micron. So we require an instrument called microscope to see that bacteria. It is very small, smallest one. Okay, next, coming to the large one. Large one here is 20 to 30 mm, micrometer, right? What is that here? Human liver or human kidney. We can see this human liver and human kidney with our naked eye, right? Now coming to the nerve cell. Just now I have shown the nerve cell diagram. Where it is present, the nerve cell? In the brain, right? The nerve cell here is branched, hexagonal branched, I said, no? That nerve cell is here, how much the measurement here is? 90 to 100 centimeter. Easily we can see, means nearly 1 meter. So think over that, how if you are removing the brain and we are removing the neuron, nerve cell or neuron, how much will you get the measurement? 1 meter, nearly 90 to 100 centimeters. So now next here is goes to a largest cell. What is that called as? Ostrich egg. Have you ever seen the ostrich egg? So here, just by this you can imagine how much big it will be. 17 to 18 centimeters. 17 into 18 centimeters. Once you calculate, then you will get one of the number. By that you can imagine how much the big ostrich egg will be. Means here it is the largest. In this, what do you have understood, children? Smallest one here is bacteria. Largest one here is a ostrich egg. So for this we require a microscope to see. For this we need not to require a microscope. With our naked eye, you can observe it. Right. So when coming In all this, they have particular shape, I have shown you, right? And to some of the cells, they don't have particular shape. So, example we take as amoeba. Amoeba is not having the particular shape. So here, this is called as amoeba. This is called as amoeba, right? This amoeba is not having particular shape. It is no definite shape structure. It is irregular in shape, right? It contains pseudopodia, and inside a round shape is called as vacuole, where it will store the food. And it is nucleus. By that nucleus, what is the role of nucleus? It controls the whole cell. Okay, this is called as amoeba, right? And this is called as chlamydomonas. These two are unicellular. Not only these two, children, you can see all these. This is called paramecium. This is called as euglena, and this is called as yeast. And these are called as bacteria. Chlamydomonas, amoeba, paramecium, euglena, yeast, bacteria. Or two types here. You can see rod shaped bacteria and you can see cocci. What is this? We will go for next class, then I can give you clarity. So amoeba, you got an structure of amoeba. So here, children, this amoeba is a irregular in structure. It is not having particular shape. It will change its body. Okay, when it is moving, it will push its body front and back. Front and back. So that this amoeba can go for locomotion. Okay, as it is helping to move, so who are helping here? This is called as pseudopodia. Pseudopodia means, pseudo means what here? False. Podia means feet. Means pseudopodia is acting as a false feet of amoeba to move from one place to the other place. So why I given this example? Because here you have certain shapes. Right? To some of the organisms, certain shapes are not present. They may be also irregular. Right? So that I given an example of amoeba to you. Correct? So, before going, by this, we completed our topic. And I want to introduce one of the instrument to you, children. I want to introduce one of the instrument. Why? Because just now I said to you here, cells like bacteria you cannot see with your naked eye. For that, we require one of the instrument that is called as microscope. Yes, we require a microscope. So, shall I introduce a microscope to you? This is a microscope. Right? Which microscope it is? Compound microscope. Okay, which microscope it is? Compound microscope. Zacharias Johnson has introduced this microscope, right? So, from topic 3, from next lesson onwards, we are going to use this microscope for each and every activity. Okay, so before going to that, I have to introduce this now. So, what is this microscope? What purpose we are using this microscope? I will say you some information to you, right? So, children, you can observe here. Iris. Where is iris? This is iris. Right? This is called as iris. And next, drawing, draw tube. Where is draw tube? This is called as draw tube. Okay? And next, where is body tube? See here. There you can find a body tube. This is called as body tube. And these two which are there, these two, this one and as well as this one. These two, what you will use for a movement of the body tube, up and down. Up and down for the movement of the body tube. Right? This is called what? For adjusting this body tube we are using. So you call this as coarse adjustment. What do you call? Coarse adjustment. And below this you can see small one where only little bit they are moving. These are called as fine adjustment. You can find, see the children in the chart. Fine adjustment. Right? And what is this called as? See, it is moving. Revolving it is. Right? And what is this called as? Nose piece. This are called as nosebleeds. There is a connection between the eyes, eyepiece. This is eyepiece and this is nosebleeds. There is a connection between the nose, eyepiece as well as nosebleeds. Right? Here how many nearly? Three will be there, children. Three nose pieces will be there. Only one eyepiece will be there. Right? Next. This is called what? Stage. Where we will keep the slide over here. This is called as stage. And this you can see, these are called as clips. These are called as clips. You can see on the chart also, these are called as clips. Where? Useful for the hold the slide on the stage. Right? And next. This is called as condenser. This is called as condenser. Have you seen condenser? You can see, this is called as condenser. What is the role of condenser? I'll say. Before that, below the condenser you can see the, I'm rotating, this is called as, what is that? Reflector. Okay, reflector. What is the use of reflector? The light focus on this reflector, on this mirror, so that light will be entered into the condenser. So it can focus easily on the slide, so you can see the image on the slide clearly. Right? This is a reflector where the light focus on the reflector, so that will reflect the light to the condenser, and this condenser will focus the light to the slide, so that from the eyepiece and with the help of nose piece you can see the object, image clearly on the slide. Whatever it is there, you can see clearly. And this is called as base. Okay, this is called as base. Base, this is called as base, and this is called as foot, and this is called as arm. What is this called as? Arm. Because I am holding the microscope, right? How can I hold the microscope? With the help of the arm. If I am catching the arm, so that I can hold the microscope. Eyepiece, right? Body tube, broad tube, body tube, nose, revolving nose, right? Revolving tube, here nose piece, stage, clips. Stage is used for keeping the slide, and this condenser, reflector, base, and foot, right? So here, if you are keeping the eyepiece 10x lens, 10x length if you are keeping, here 3 are there, right? In this 3 you can keep 4x lens or 40x, right? Or 100x. So what is the connection between these here? When 10x if you are keeping, if in this nose piece if you are keeping 4x, you have to multiply the 4x with the 10x. If you have to multiply with the 4x and as well as 10x. If you are multiplying, how much the magnification will become? 40x. So that you can get the clarity of the image which is on the slide. If you are taking 40x here 10x, 40 into 10x, how much? 400. So you will get the 400x magnification to see the object on the slide clearly. So that is the connection between the eyepiece as well as the nosepiece. Is it clear, children? This is about the microscope. It's a compound microscope. It is very much useful for the activities so far coming units. Okay. So, what we have discussed today? I am going to ask the questions. Please note down the questions. Write the differences between the unicellular and multicellular organisms. Okay. Next. Please write down the, draw the shapes of the cells in a human body. Draw the shapes of the cells in a human body. Draw. Okay, I am giving the shapes I have given. You have to draw them.